सेल्फ लव, इज इट अ न्यू एज फैड?
नो.
इज इट अ लग्जरी और अ नेसेसिटी?
डेफिनेटली नेसेसिटी.
इज इट फॉर पीपल हु हैव लोड्स ऑफ फ्री टाइम ऑन देयर हैंड्स?
Nope.
Does self-love mean going out to the salons every now and then and pampering myself with fancy treatments and going out to shop to make myself look better?
No.
And what better way to love myself than to indulge myself in the pleasure of eating a cheese-loaded pizza with extra toppings? Well, sometimes.
Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new here, welcome. I'm Kasturi. I make videos about minimalism, sustainable living, kanda patata also, apparently. But yeah, minimalism, sustainable living and health. So if you guys think you're interested in something like that, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon next to it so YouTube will notify you whenever my next video comes up. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about self-love. Many people mistakenly believe that self-love is the same as narcissism or having a big ego. No, it's not. Self-love means having a high regard for your own well-being and happiness. It means taking care of your own needs. It does not mean temporarily focusing on your wellness to please others. Self-love means not settling for less than you deserve. Loving yourself doesn't mean you think you're the smartest, intelligent, you know, most talented, most beautiful person in the world. Instead, when you love yourself, you accept your so-called weaknesses, so-called shortcomings, accept your mistakes as something that makes you who you are. When you love yourself, you have compassion for yourself and your well-being. You take care of yourself like you take care of a friend who's sad or is in distress. You treat yourself kindly. You don't criticize yourself. I'm going to share 6 things that can help you understand self-love better and how you can practice the same to take a step towards knowing yourself and loving yourself more. Stop comparing yourself. Comparison is a huge obstruction between you and loving yourself. And we are not usually very good when it comes to comparison, right? Instead, we take our greatest flaws and compare them to someone else's greatest success. In short, comparison with other people's life is meant for us to feel bad about ourselves and our life. But we have to bring our attention to the fact that everyone has different life experiences and each one of us comes from different walks of life. No two humans have the exact same life experiences, and that's what makes you different from me, right? Instead, realize that you write your story and I write mine. Realize that you can't compare your life to someone else's because no matter how well you know them, you never know how they feel or how they perceive their life. Instead, spend your time and energy to live the best life that you can and build your own path. Be kind and speak love to yourself. In one of my videos about mental health, I mentioned that we have to stop beating ourselves mentally for not being perfect because that's just plain impossible. Perfection does not exist. God is perfection, and that's about it. That negative internal dialogue that tells us that we are not good enough is depriving you from exploring yourself and embracing your imperfections. Your imperfections is what makes you unique, right? When you start thinking good about yourself, your actions align and you feel good in your own skin and body. Your thoughts are the first step towards self-love. If a thought pops up in your head saying, I'm not good enough, or I can't do this, or I don't know what to do anymore, how does that make you feel? Probably not so good, right? Then it's a sign to think a different thought, to think differently. Try to replace that with something kinder. For example, I'm just so lost and confused can be replaced with, I'm doing the best I can to move forward. This flow of positive and motivating thoughts can drastically change the way you see and feel about yourself. Learn to trust your gut. If you feel that something is wrong, then it is. That inner voice that tells you that this person is not good enough for you and for your mental health. Or you feel that you will be in a bad situation if you take a step any further than this, then don't. Listen to yourself and take action accordingly. Acknowledge your gut feeling, your instincts, and learn to trust it more than trusting anybody else. Serve yourself some healthy habits. Your health is the biggest asset that you have. So make some room for healthy habits in your day. Eat food that soothes your soul. It is a fuel for your body. Cut down on food that is just good for your tongue and not for your body. Include wholesome nutritious food and superfoods to keep yourself active so that you can maintain a state of calm and self-satisfaction. Along with eating healthy, moving your body, exercising can help you feel good about your skin and your overall health. Exercise just not to get it done and get over with it, like a checklist tick mark or because you have to, but because you care about yourself and your body. Don't feel like working out, go for a walk in a park. Take your pet along. Take care, just not for your physical health, but your mental and emotional health too. Acknowledge your needs. Addressing or vocalizing our own needs is often mistaken with selfishness. Keeping ourselves first is never selfish. It's a sign of love and compassion. We want other people to understand and care about our feelings and love us unconditionally. But how can you even expect that behavior from other people, including your family and friends, when you yourself don't acknowledge your needs and feelings? This can only happen when you spend time with yourself. By that, I don't mean sitting alone watching a movie, but spending time with your true self away from distractions. The more you spend time with yourself and prioritize yourself before everyone and everything, the more you will realize what truly makes you happy and content. Which brings me to my next suggestion, the power of repeating mantra. I truly believe that meditation can heal our souls. But that is a much bigger topic and can be difficult for someone to start with rigorous meditation who has never tried it before. But all of us at some point of time have tried singing, right? When you're singing a song, you forget everything, your surroundings, work stress, etc. You're focusing only on the lyrics and the tune. Similarly, when you're repeating a mantra, other multiple thoughts swimming in the mind disappear and the mind shifts towards mental clarity and stillness. It gives you a feeling of being one with ourselves. I would suggest you start with Soham. The Soham meditation is a simple but powerful technique that uses the breath and the repetition of a mantra to quiet the mind and relax the body. This meditation can help you take your awareness from a state of pressure and shrunken thoughts to a state of expanded consciousness. All you have to do is find a comfortable position, normalize the inflow and outflow of breath, and close your eyes. Gently begin to repeat the mantra. Think the word so on inhalation and hum on exhalation. You can start with 5 minutes and increase your time accordingly. The meaning of soham is explained in the description below. You can go ahead and read about it. That's all for today, you guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and comment down below telling me how you practice self-love. And if you want to see more videos on self-love, let me know in the comments down below. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.